talk to Santiago Ponzinibbio, who's coming off a massive win himself. Hello, Santiago. How are you, my friend?
What's up, Ariel? How are you, brother?
Hey, congratulations. Congratulations to your country. Can you put into words what these last few days have been like for someone who is so proud to be from Argentina, to see everything that's going on? What has it been like for you?
Crazy. That's a dream. We love soccer. It's on the culture, right? Yesterday when the Argentina players are right in the country, that's the biggest mobilization of the people, no? 6 million alone, 6 million people go to the street. That's people completely crazy. We love soccer. It's in our culture, and yeah, that's a dream, and that's I think the Messi deserve, the team deserve. I'm so proud, I'm so happy.
Where did you watch the final on Sunday?
With some friends here in Miami. It's a lot of Argentinian people here, and it's very fun. Yeah, I was with some friends. Yeah.
So when they're up 2-0 and then they tie 2, like, could you tell me about, I was watching it and I was nervous. I wanted Messi to win. I wanted Argentina to win because I wanted to see him. But as someone who is Argentinian, that role, I mean, have you ever been this nervous watching a sporting event?
No, never, man. That's super crazy. Super crazy. That's crazy game. This is an amazing final, you know. That's, I think now is everything perfect, you know, for we won and everything perfect. But in the moment, man, when they do 2 goals in 3 minutes, I can't believe that, man. And when they do the 3-3, the penalty, that was crazy, bro. It was crazy. But thank God, you know, the guys, I think everyone in the Argentina team is, you know, very focused and won the World Cup. Doesn't matter what happened. They're always focused. They put a lot of tension. You imagine, you won. They're playing so good. And in 3 minutes, they didn't 2 goals. And that's crazy for mentally, right? I think they're still, you know, with the hungry, they're still, you know, focused and they do it. That's amazing.
How did you react when they won? Did you cry?
Crazy, yeah, of course. Crazy, crazy, completely crazy. I go to the street and I spend probably more than 12 hours in the street, playing songs, you know, with a lot of people, dancing. That's crazy day. Crazy, everybody. A lot of Argentinian people. That's amazing energy.
Are you surprised by the reaction back home, like the amount of people that are showing up, the celebrations, or did you expect something like that if they won?
Because I know. Soccer in Argentina, you know, it's different, right? This people love soccer. We are very passionate and everyone waiting for that. We're very close, you know, but the last one in 86, we are very close with a lot of problems. Now we have a Messi in the sweet spot and it's a lot of, you know, expectation about this happening. And yeah, I know they're going to be crazy, crazy. I saw a lot of videos, you know, the things that happens in Argentina and man, crazy.
When you saw them lose to Saudi Arabia, did you think that they would get back on track and win it all, or did you get nervous?
Yeah, no. I still have a lot of fear, you know, in the Argentina. Yeah, they're good, you know, and that can happen, you know, that can happen when you play, you know, and when you start, you know. No, I'm still very, very
confident.
They say the word. Confident.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Someone just asked me the question, but I'm curious what you'd say. They asked me if now is Messi finally out of the shadows of Maradona? Is he viewed differently, or will Maradona always be above Messi? What do you think? Where do you rank the two?
Man, the numbers, the Messi are unbelievable. I think he have, you know, longest career, you know, long time in the high level. Maradona doing amazing things, but that's very short career, very short time for he have a crazy life.
Yeah.
And I think the Messi put better number for he very professional. I think he sustained the level for so many years. And yeah, I think, you know, Messi is unbelievable right now what he did.
You ever meet him?
Yeah.
When?
I met a time ago. I have a very good friend friend, the boss, and sometimes I talk with him with the phone, and yeah.
Wow.
It's good.
Nice guy?
Yeah. Very nice. Very humble. And also, when that happened with the Canelo thing, and I told him, and my friend sent everything for him, and he loved, you know. He watched everything, you know, and he loved. You know?
Wow. Yeah, you had his back with the Canelo thing, with the jersey, right?
Yeah, of course, man. I'm pissed off. But that's happened. That's on the past. That's Canelo say.
He said sorry.
Yeah, say sorry and that's it, you know.
Yeah, that was a crazy thing. I didn't agree with Canelo. It was making a big deal out of nothing.
And we know. This is what I say. You can judge for one little thing and one guy. You know, if you watch the video, he's not doing nothing. First thing. And the second thing, you can judge a Messi for a little thing when he have a... Look at the career. He's super professional, you know. It's not only the best. He's an example, you know. He's a humble guy, you know, very... And I think, you know, the reaction are bad, but he say sorry. That's it. That's about the past.
Yeah. Are you going to go back home to celebrate?
Man, yeah, probably. I need to do something in the United States. I'm still in Florida right now, but... Yeah, I need to go to Argentina.
Yeah, and there's a rumor that he's going to come to Miami too, that Messi's going to play for Miami.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah, for the Inter.
So he'll be the second most famous person living in Miami behind you from Argentina.
This is what I listen. I wish he coming to the Inter, he buying a percentage for the team. We will see, man. If he coming to living here, that's going to be amazing.
And so a good stretch for you. Of course, we just saw you. You had the big win over Alex Morono. Did he surprise you? Like, you had the Robbie Lawler fight. He takes the fight on 4 days' notice or something. Did he surprise you how tough he was?
Yes. That's the change, everything, right? I prepared for Robbie Lawler. That's a Sapo guy, boxer. You know, the guy is unilateral, you know, his style. No. And they put me this kid, you know, they're coming very good. He won in 8 in the last 10, 4 in a row. And, you know, a little heavy, we're doing 180 pounds. You know, I'm the way when they offer me that. But, yeah, I'm surprised. He doing good. And I take time in the fight to adapt, to read the fight. You know, for I working for ASAP, I'm working for other things. And I believe in myself. For this, I saw, yeah, no problem. Give me anybody I want to fight. For I believe I'm a fighter. I have the ability to do the things, but take time. I know it's very fast, everything in the fight. You know, I take a couple punches. I give others. But, yeah, I'm surprised. But thank God, you know, I can finish the fight. I can put a knockout. I want my bonus, the performance. And end of the day, everything are good.
Are you happy with your performance in the fight, or because he took the fight on such short notice, did you
I
want
don't
to clean
happy.
You're not happy?
No, I'm not happy at all with the performance. I'm happy with the result. I'm happy that I can prove to myself that I still can do it. You know, these things that everything are crazy, and I still do it, especially in the fight. I take time to read. I'm a little sleepy. I take some punches, and I still can go and finish. That's good for me. But I don't like at all the way that I fight. I don't like. But it's okay. Sometimes happen. Fight is fight. Some days are good. Some days are bad. The most important, I take the victory by knockout. And, you know, and I beat a guy that coming with the 4 victories in a row. You know, that's good.
Right.
If I fight Robbie Lawler, the people going to say, Lawler is no more the same. He come and losing the fight. You know, I think Lawler is our biggest name, but if we need to talking about the moment in the career, Morono much better moment than Lawler. And it's more risky for me and everything. But I take and I did. I finished. That part are good for me. The part, the technique that I fight or the that's don't like, but as I told you, no, fight is fight. This the thing can happen.
Why do you think it went down like that? Is it just because he's a completely different fighter than Robbie or some other reason?
Yeah, it's a different fighter, you know. I prepare for something that changed everything in the last minute. You know, when I try to use my jab, I'm slippery a little bit in the cage. I don't have good posture up, and you know, different small things. Something that maybe doing the not have my best performance, but we did, you know. I think I finished the fight. I won. I'm unhappy with that.
Mm. Do you want Robbie next? Do you want to go back to the Robbie fight, or are you moving on from that?
No. Listen, the fight with Robbie, the UFC offered me to me. You know, I'm not asking for him.
Right.
I thinking that I'm gonna fight with Barbarena. This is what I'm thinking. And UFC told me, no, we have Lawler to December. In my perfect world, I wish to fight in September and in December. You know, for I fight my last fight with Michelle Pereira in May.
Mm.
Yeah, May. I'm pissed off. I lose split decision. I think they won the fight, you know. I say, give me somebody to fight in September, another fight to make it in December. And this conversation with a manager, with the people of the UFC, and they back for with this fight. But I'm not asking for that. Yeah? It's a good name. Are good. If they tell me, hey, we have Robbie now in 2 months, okay, perfect. But waiting for him, no. If I need to wait, I'm going to wait for other opportunities, right? I want to back to the top 10, you know, to have my opportunity to fight for the belt. I think I put good work in my last fight. You know, in the 12th fight, my last 12 fight, I beat 9, but 3 fights I lose, 2 are split decision. I think they both with Neil, and I think I won with Michelle Pereira, you know. And, you know, it's everything, you know. Let us talk right now. I want to back to the ranking, to back to have my opportunities.
Who makes the most sense for you, in your opinion, or who do you want the most?
I don't know. I need to check the top 10 and see who is there, you know. It's a lot of guys that I can do a good fight, you know. I think there are a lot of good strikers there, you know. We can make exciting fight, you know. I think Vicente Luque are one of that, you know. It's a good fighter. They have I need to check the rankings, you know. It's a lot of good guys there, you know. We will see what is to happen.
You know, there was that period where you were on the winning streak and you were so close and, you know, things worked out the way they did. Do you feel like when you see the top of the division, do you feel like you could beat all those top guys? Do you still have the confidence? Do you still have the belief that you could be a champion, that you can hang with the top 2-3 champion guys? You know what I mean? Like, do you feel that way right now?
Of course. I believe in myself. I know what I can do. I just only need the opportunity, you know, man. Still, I have energy. I'm healthy. I'm going to fight for that. You know, I'm going to try to take my opportunity, to take my shot for the belt.
You mentioned the judges, that you thought that you won the Pereira fight and that you've had 2 split decisions. The judging is a hot topic these days once again. It's always a hot topic in MMA, but it feels like it comes and goes. What do you think? Any thoughts on how it can be fixed? Any thoughts on what could be changed?
Man. We saw a lot of times, you know, in a lot of fights. I'm broadcasting. I call the fights. I saw so many times, you know, I don't agree with the judge, you know. And this happened with me, you know, 2 times in a row, you know. A lot of people think they want these fights. But I don't know what they need to do. But for sure, the system needs to change, man. They can finish your career.
Right.
They can, you know. That's crazy, you know. That's crazy what they can do. They have a lot of power. They need to change this system, you know, doing something better.
And I feel like part of the problem is the fighters don't really know how the judges are going to judge the fight. So, like, it's not like you have to fight based on what they are going to try to look for, but I feel like there's a disconnect between the judges and the fighters, right? Like, you don't even know what they're looking at or what they're trying to score, right?
Yeah, I don't know. If I need to talk with my last fight with Pereira, you know that I lose the first round, but in the second round, I put a little more punches. And also when the round is finished, I put a takedown. I put a takedown in my head. I say, okay, I won the round. I don't want to spend too much energy in the floor. Just put the takedown, get up, say, okay, the second round is me. In the third round, I go, I put more than double the punches and the kicks. I say, okay, I won the second, the third round. My corner thinking the same, you know, everybody. And the judge say I lose. I think one judge, I don't remember, but I think one judge said I lose the 3 rounds. Is it another judge said I lose the second and the third and the second and the first round? But that's impossible. You know, I put more punches, I put a takedown, you know, in the third round I put more than double the punches. You know, I can understand what the judge. I get why. I can understand what is the what are they thinking, you know?
Yeah, it's crazy. And then you guys lose money, right? You get half your pay if you lose these fights, and your ranking.
Half the money, opportunities, man, it's crazy. For this, when I sit in the corner, and I know the fight is not going good, I'm not feeling good. That's the point. I'm not feeling good in the fight. For all this change, I'm not feeling good. For this, you asking me about the performance, I tell you, I don't like it at all. I'm not feeling good. And I ask him to my corner, what do you think? And he told me, we lose the two rounds. He doing to put pressure on me, for he knows I can do better. I say, okay, you know, I don't want to go to the judge again, you know. In my opinion, I think they won the second, I lose the first round. But it's still close fight, I don't want to go to the judge. And when my corner say that, I say, okay, I'm going to finish this guy. Doesn't matter what happened. I'm going to put everything to try to finish. I don't want to go to the judge. And thank God I can do, you know. But, yeah, it's a lot of stress, you know. I think go to the judge is a lot of stress.
Wouldn't it be great if you knew what the score was in real time, open scoring? Like if you knew after every round how they scored it, so at least you actually knew where you stood in the fight. Wouldn't that be good? Wouldn't that be a nice luxury to have?
Wow, yeah, that's right? Very good.
You like that?
Yeah, of course.
Man. I think they should do that. Yeah.
If we get out in the moment and you understand what is happening in the fight, I think that's...
They put it on the screen, they put it on the broadcast. All right.
I think that's a very good idea. You can so between you fighting, that can help a lot.
Yeah. It's like, let's compare it to the World Cup final on Sunday. France knew that they were down 2-0. They knew they had to score twice. They knew. It wasn't like, oh, what's the score? We're not sure. You know what I mean? You should know where you stand.
Right. Of course. I think that's a good idea. I think that can help a lot. Yeah.
Thank you. Next time you do the broadcast in Spanish, you should say that on the broadcast. My friend Ariel told me this.
Idea.
Yes. You could say it's your own idea. You don't have to say it's mine.
Okay. I like
it. Okay.
It's a good one.
I appreciate it. How soon do you want to come back?
We will see, man. I wish to fight soon. I stay active, you know, try to do 3 fights a year. If I can do 4, that's going to be a perfect, but I know it's more difficult, but minimum 3 fights and stay busy. And what I told you, take good opportunities to come back to the ranking and take my opportunity for the belt. You know, that's my main goal.
Sure. And you feel healthy, no more problem. You had that bad stretch of so much things happening. Your body feels good, back to 100% or close?
Yeah. I feel happy.
Good.
Yeah, thank God.
Thank God. Are you still partying? Are you still celebrating? Or has the partying died down now from Sunday?
No, still partying. Still partying.
Still more going on?
Party, yeah.
Incredible.
Of course.
Those, I can't get enough of all the videos of all those people on the highway, at his house, at his grandmother. I can't get enough of it.
Yeah. That's amazing, man. We are passionate. That's we are. And yeah, man. It's a World Cup, man. This not happen every day.
Sure.
This deserves a big celebration.
But he's still not as good as Ronaldo, in my opinion. It's still Ronaldo 1. Nah, I'm joking. I'm joking.
I think you're the only guy that thinking on that after what has happened.
I'm joking, my friend. I'm joking. Well, congratulations to you and your country. Congratulations on the win. Very happy for you. Very happy for the whole country. Very happy for you on the victory. And thank you for coming on. As always, good to talk to you, Santiago.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate your time, man. See you next one.
Yes, sir. There he is, Santiago Ponzinibbio, a very proud Argentinian. They're still on a high.